who dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty.
I will say of the Lord, He is my refuge and my fortress. My God, in Him I will trust.
肯定的，他必救你脱离无秒人的网络，脱离致命的瘟疫。
He will cover you with His feathers. He will shelter you with His wings. His faithful promises are your armor and your protection.
Do not be afraid of the terrors of the night, nor the arrow of flies in the day.
Do not dread the disease that stalks in darkness, nor the disaster that strikes at midday.
虽有千人扑倒在你身旁，万人扑倒在你右边，他却不得临近你。
Just open your eyes and see how the wicked are punished.
எனக்கு அடிக்கலமாய் இருக்கிற உன்னதமான கர்த்தரை உனக்கு தாவரமாக கொண்டேன்.
No evil will conquer you, no plague will come near your home.
For He will order His angels to protect you wherever you go.
他们必用手托着举起你，免得你的脚碰在石头上。
You trample over the lions and the cobras. You crush the lions and serpents under your feet.
阿文年里的这万载一起的伯利亚，阿文的米利天，阿文年那么的阿伦的伯利亚，阿文的乌烟的阿里克的雷米贝。
When they call on me, I will answer. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue and honor them.
私は長寿をもって彼を満ち足らせ、我が救を彼に示すであろう。
Set free by the blood on the cross.
settled 4 loans with 1 breakthrough sale. Thank the Lord for the prophetic word given to RLC that this is the year of taking possession. This June 2022, I received my breakthrough with a sale of a property which enabled me to settle 4 personal loans which I had 7 years ago for my business. All honor and glory to our Abba Father. Amen.
Hey everyone, welcome back to Rhema Word with Holy Communion. We're so glad to have you join us today. We appreciate your support. It helps keep the ministry going for you and also for others. Today we're going to look at standing still and you will see the solution. So we know that God has the solution before the problem even arose. He has the solution even when you're just stressing out about it. You're thinking about how am I going to overcome it? Well, God already has the solution to overcome the obstacles. But sometimes we can be conditioned to think that, well, this is the way it's going to be. There's no way I'm going to get out of this situation. There's no way that God is going to able to lift me out from this misery. Well, God is able to do it. So in Exodus 14, we see, and Moses said to the people, "Do not be afraid. Stand still and see the salvation of the Lord, which he will accomplish for you today. The Lord will fight for you. You need only to be still." Now, the word is there, see the salvation that is Yeshua. Now, the word salvation is the supernatural wholeness, well-being, healing, peace, prosperity, deliverance, and transformation. But it didn't mean that things are going to happen overnight. Sometimes we want that instant miracle. We want that instant thing, instant miracle, that instant breakthrough to take place. Well, sometimes it's not going to be an easy road. Just like if God gave you a promise, and God gave you a word, sometimes it takes time, or sometimes there are obstacles that are going to be there. Just like when God told Joshua to conquer the land, it wasn't suddenly that Joshua was able to just walk in and take the land as it is, but there were already the existing inhabitants that were there. So he had to go through the obstacles itself. He had to pass through those places that we see about. So what happens when you see Jesus? Well, when you see Jesus, you are able to see miracles. In Acts chapter 3 verse 4, "And fixing his eyes on him with John, Peter said, 'Look at us. Silver and gold I do not have, but what I do have, I give you. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, rise up and walk.'" And so we see that the lame man was healed. But it wasn't by their own power, the disciples' own power, that the man was healed, but it was from God himself. So in verse 12, "So when Peter saw it, he responded to the people, 'Men of Israel, why do you marvel at this? Or why look so intently at us as though by our own power, our own godliness, we have made this man walk?'" So it wasn't because of Paul. It wasn't because of how good they were, or whether they were so confident, or whether they were charismatic people. It wasn't because of that. It's because he was relying on God. He knew that God had the solution. He knew God had the healing touch. He knew that God had the breakthrough, and he was pointing them to see that the power comes from Christ alone. The power comes from God alone. In Colossians 1 verse 17, "He is before all things, and in him all things hold together." So thank God for all the promotions. Thank God for the good things. Thank God for food on the table. Thank God for a good family. Thank God for a good spouse. Thank God for good kids. Thank God for the ways that God has blessed you with, but they are not your focus. They are not your priority. Sometimes we can get so carried away with the blessing and not the blesser itself. Sometimes we get so carried away, we pray to God, God, please give me a spouse, or God, give me a boyfriend, a girlfriend. And we get so carried away and so focused on the spouse and not in the things of God anymore. Or we get so carried away with God, I really want this job, I really want this career. And finally, we get what we wish, but at the same time, we are making decisions that are away from God, or taking our priority, our focus from God itself. God is the one who brought about the blessings in the first place. So we seek God and not the blessing. So just like we see in an atom, we learn in school before about the protons and the electrons and what holds it together. But yet when you split the atom, there's that tremendous power that is released. And even just like that, God is holding all of us together. He is before all things and he knows all things. He holds the whole world in the palm of his hands. Anytime you feel stressed, anytime you feel worried, anytime you feel that doubt creep in, that is the devil telling you and filling you with fear, telling you that there's no such thing as a breakthrough. There's no such thing as healing. That's the devil creeping in and telling you that the situation won't be resolved, or the relationship won't be restored. But actually, God is the one who holds all things in His hands. So when you seek God and not the blessings, you see that the blessings flow. So when we see Jesus, we are able to see the miracle. When we see God, when we look, when our focus is on God, when our focus is not on the things that are around us in our own natural eye, of course, we are dealing with the situation, we are being realistic with the outcome that is happening. At the same time, we are reliant on what God says in His Word. We know that God is the God Almighty who created the sun, He created the stars, He created the moon, He created the trees that are around us. He sent forth food on the table. He was the one who provided everything for us, and we know that He is able to take us through. As He was faithful before, He will be faithful now, because He's the same forevermore. In Isaiah 53, "But He was pierced for our transgressions, He was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was upon Him, and by His wounds we are healed." So every need that you have, every want that you have, everything, every healing that you need is met on the cross. So with every lash that He has taken, you have been healed. With every lash that was on Jesus Christ, your situation, your breakthrough has already happened, has already come. So right now, whatever is bothering you, any disagreement, any fight, any relationship gone bad, any sickness, any illness, any disease, or even any bad habits that you are facing, well, right now, picture it even as Jesus was lashed on the cross, that 39 stripes, that 39 lashes. Picture that all those things have already been taken away. The sickness has been taken away. The restoration has already come. The breakthrough has already come. With every lash that was on Jesus Christ, He was marred beyond human recognition. When Jesus Christ, that perfect human being, went up to the cross and His nails and His hands were nailed to the cross, picture that your breakthrough has already come. Picture that illness has already disappeared. Picture that your recovery is already complete. Picture that the finances and whatever's blocking you from receiving the full prosperity of what God wants you to have is broken. The blockade that was on Him, on you, is broken. If every lash that was on Jesus Christ, picture that you have already found the solution. Picture that you have already got your breakthrough. Because with every lash that was on Jesus Christ, we know that it was a blood purchase blessing. We know that Christ has already paid the price for us. In Revelations, who is the one that is worthy to open the scroll? It is Jesus Christ. Who is the one worthy to open the will and testament? It is Jesus Christ. Because it was the cross that paid the price for us. It was the blood purchase blessing. And so because of every lash that was on Jesus Christ, the nails that were on Him, and He hung on that cross, we know that there's no problem that's too big or too small for God to handle. And we know that even as God was faithful to us before in our little prayers, we know that He will be faithful to us again in our big prayers. We know that He will be faithful to us again in all the things that concern us, because He truly cares for each and every one of us.
Let's sing this beautiful chorus. I sing praises to Your name, O Lord, praises to Your name, O God, for Your name is great and greatly to be praised. I give glory to Your name, O Lord, glory to Your name, O Lord, for Your name is great and greatly to be praised. Brianda la bara shalom baraka. Irianda la bara irianda la Messiah. The Lord Jesus Christ said, "Take and eat. This is My body broken for you." This cup is a new covenant in My blood, poured out for you for the forgiveness of all your sins. Father, we release the anointing of the Holy Spirit, even as the blood of Christ, and apply all the brothers and sisters in the household that are watching this, we thank you, Lord Jesus. Truly, you propel us beyond to be the lay hold of all the possession, despite of all the obstacles, all the negative news. Lord, that we're going to be able to walk in the possession and the destiny you have for us. I see the Lord pouring out His anointing, and it is His enabling power. Come to Him, come to Him. Receive that enabling. Don't go without a day without seeking His presence, and receive that strength. They're going to cause you to propel beyond, taking possession with His presence. Neck condition, throat be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. That migraine be gone, that ear ringing on the left ear be gone even right now. The abdomen be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. Fertility, recreative. Great opportunity. Don't despise the day of small beginning. Possessing the property that is in your heart's desire.
There's someone that you feel that you already have enough, but the Lord said He has much more, much more, much more for you, so that you are able to be a blessing. And the Lord is also saying to someone, He is your provider. He is your provider. So the Lord says, do not worry. Do not worry about anything. But He is your provider. More doors of opportunity is opening up in Jesus' name. More doors of opportunities are opening up in Jesus' name. The spine problem be healed right now in Jesus' name. Body be strengthened in Jesus' name. Someone you have doubts of the things that, but the Lord said what He has for you is the best. What He has for you is the best. Therefore the Lord said, just receive the things that He has for you. Do not close up. Do not close up. Do not doubt of His love for you. Someone you feel that your leg have no strength, be healed in Jesus' name. Promotions in Jesus' name. And someone, the Lord is anointing your hand. The Lord is anointing your hand to get wealth. Whatever you lay your hands on will be prosperous in Jesus' name. The Lord is releasing special anointing to get wealth in Jesus' name. And the students, you are able to do well in Jesus' name. Be the top and not the tail in Jesus' name. Supernatural favor in Jesus' name.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord cause His face shine upon you. Be gracious unto you. The Lord smile on you and release you His favor. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Amen.